right. What's going on? It's the Delegation, and we have a new segment on our show called Delegationship. What it is, it's the viewers, they send in their questions, and we answer them from our point of view, being honest and real about it.
Yeah, so if you have any questions, just leave it in the comments below or send us a DM on Instagram, and we'll try our best to answer them. So our very first question is, when is a man ready for a relationship? Do they have to, is there a right age for being in the right relationship? We'll let our man, Mr. Sound Bath North, answer the question first.
I think that depends, obviously, on the person and where they're at mentally to be in a for both people to be in a relationship. So it's really important to make sure that you know everyone's on the same page on what they want, I think.
So when you're ready for a relationship? Did that question ever cross your mind, or did you just let the feeling, or just let, was that like a burden for you?
I'm gonna say, for me to answer every question that you're gonna ask, ultimately in a relationship, right? When you want something bad enough, it doesn't matter what you're going through, you're gonna go for it.
Yeah. Right? So it doesn't matter about your achievements.
Not really, right? I think those type of things, like when you're in a relationship and you're going for achievements, that's gonna put a strain on your relationship, but that's not gonna ultimately finish a relationship.
Yeah.
Right? When you want something bad enough, you're gonna stick it out no matter what.
You're gonna make it work.
You're gonna make it work.
Yeah. Exactly.
Right?
I agree with
that. How many girls, girls do I know that have been in relationships where it's like their friends tell them no? On paper, the guy is horrible.
Yeah.
Let's say he's like a starving artist type of thing, right? But they still go after him because they want him no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The odds are stacked against them, but they want him and they stay with them.
Yeah.
Right?
No, I agree. What they're trying to ask, it's like, do you have to be financially because back then I used to think I should be financially ready.
Right.
Have my own place. Mm-hmm. No one's trying to bring a girl over to their parents' house and then sneak in, right, kind of thing.
Yeah.
It just kind of, but I think they're trying to see, I had this thought before, I should be a certain thing to take on a serious relationship.
Right.
So I think that question is like that. Is there certain accomplishments or thing where you should be at to be ready for a relationship?
It helps, but I don't think it's necessary.
Has that ever crossed your mind?
Yeah, it's like, you got to know where you're at, right? So for you, there are going to be things that you're like, I'm at this point in my life.
Yeah.
So there is a little bit of expectation of the other person to be at a certain level for sure.
Yeah.
But as Jay was saying, if you want something
exactly,
bad enough, you'll find ways to work through that.
Yeah.
If there's any discrepancy.
Yeah. It's not does that stop you from being attracted to girls or wanting to talk to them? Not really.
No.
Right. Exactly. What are your thoughts, Drew? Did you ever have that right age or right time in life where you think you should?
I think initially when you don't have a girlfriend, you think all those things matter, right? But I mean, the age thing definitely doesn't matter anymore for sure. I mean, if you're just not with the right person, then you don't want to do any of those things, right?
Exactly.
So at the end of the day, it's just about the other person, right? It's like, I can say all these things about myself. Oh, I want this done. I want this amount of money, all this stuff like that. But you also need that the give and take between the person you're with, right? If they're on the same level as you, then there's no reason to force any of those things.
Yeah. I could honestly say that the times when I thought I wasn't ready and I wasn't ready, where my long-term relationship, the relationship worked out. Whereas when I thought I was mentally ready, personal and financial, wise, it just didn't work out. So it brings back to the same thing. When you want something to work, you're going to make it work no matter what.
Exactly.
Yeah. And you can't time because what are you going to do? You're okay, I'm ready now. And you think the fucking girls are just going to come flocking.
Exactly.
It
doesn't
exactly.
Sure, it can help, but...
You're I'm ready now. And then it's what you think is just fucking going to...
Right. You ever been in a situation, you're dead broke, yeah. right? But you want something so bad. So like, and you end up buying it regardless, even though you know it's a bad decision, but yeah. you want it bad enough yeah. that you just do it anyways.
Yeah, yeah. exactly.
Right?
So, I think like if you, at the end of the day, if you want to make it work, you're going to make it work.
You're going to make it work.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what I think.
Thank yeah. you. But you also, like, what about like like with all those questions being like the right, then you're not at peace with yourself. So you can't be in a relationship anyway, right? If they're asking that question, because they're also asking, should you be like, is there a certain, achievements and insecurities you overcome before being ready in a relationship?
I mean,
like, do you have to be? I agree, but then at the same time, again, if you want it to be,
I think it's like, you know, you can't expect the other person to be like perfect and have everything like aligned, and it's like, okay, now we can be together. Part of being in a relationship is working through things,
exactly.
Right?
Yeah, so it's like, we're together,
you know, asking all that stuff to be resolved before you get into
exactly.
a relationship is like, ah, that's kind of not how it works.
Yeah, you know? Right. And sometimes you encounter issues and stuff that you didn't think was wrong before.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Before, for sure. Like, you can't, it's good to be prepared, but at the same time, you just got to let shit be.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
So I guess to answer that, is there a right time and a right age?
No, there isn't. There isn't. Man, it's like having kids, right? It's like, oh, like I want to have this and that. It does help, right? Yeah. Like being financially ready, having this, yeah. it helps, right? But yeah. there's no perfect time. Because yeah. when that time comes, something else is going to arise. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be an issue. And then like, oh, I have to tackle that. Sometimes you just got to jump into it and just do it. Mm-hmm. Like business plans, having a baby, getting married, being in a relationship,
yeah.
whatever. Yeah. Sometimes you just got to put your back against the wall.
Yeah.
And let your nuts hang and do it.
Literally. So, shit, I lost my train of thought. it's obviously the smart to like be prepared and whatever.
Right,
it helps, but then like some shit you just gotta let mm-hmm. Let it be.
Let it be, and then you know, like grow together, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Cause you can have the perfect resume, but if the feeling's not there, it's not gonna work.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I feel that's more important than the resume itself.
Yeah. yeah.
Right.
Yeah. And I also find like when the reason why people ask that is because that's a lot of excuses that people use to end a relationship.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, I'm not ready. Like, it's not where I want to be. Do you think,
right.
that,
yeah, right,
do you
right,
think
right.
that's, do you think that's bullshit then? Or?
Yeah. yeah. I think it's just a nice way to put someone down.
Have you guys ever used that to end a relationship?
I think, yeah, I have. I think so.
By saying like that, like I'm just not in like a...
Yeah, it's not you, it's me.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah. yeah.
So what do you mean by that? You just putting it in a nice way?
I'm just packaging it and making it nice so she doesn't... lessens the pain.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I think we've all done that.
Yeah, we've all done that, man.
Yeah. Yeah. So when the girl says they're not, it's just, they're just not feeling it.
I think so. When a girl does that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because the thing is, hey, like 2 weeks later, she's out with somebody else, right? It's like, yo, you just told me you weren't ready for a relationship. What happened? Right?
A lot of girls be like, oh, I just want to like take this time to find myself. Because I've like...
What the fuck does that mean? You had your whole life. Like, you know who you are. Right?
No, but they can be like, you know, I was like young when I got into the relationship. It feels like I didn't have enough alone time. It feels like I'm at the age where I want to experience stuff on my own. Mm, right. Figure stuff out on your own. But at the same time, if you have the right partner to go through life experiences with, that it shouldn't even matter, right? You should like want your partner there to experience those things
yeah.
with you.
I think that's... Like the lamest excuse, like I gotta figure myself out, so I can't be with you. Like I think that's a lame excuse. Like what does that even mean? Right?
It means they don't fuck with you.
That's what it means. Yeah. Ultimately, that's what it means, right? Yeah.
So, what is the modern day? What is the modern day man looking for in a relationship?
Well, for me personally, I would say. Someone I can vibe with is mm-hmm. very important. Like we have the same chemistry, we get each other. But more important than that, for something long term, it's how do we work together, mm-hmm. right? How do we work towards goals? How do we accomplish them? How do we complement each other? How do we compromise with another? mm-hmm. right? Those are more important, mm-hmm. all right? Because the thing is like, yeah, like, oh, I love you, puppy eyes, but the spark honeymoon phase, that's only going to last for so long. Mm-hmm. Then you got to deal with real shit in life, right? It's how we work together and accomplish those things.
Yeah.
That's important.
Yeah. It's not some movie type shit where, yeah.
It's nice, don't get me wrong. You need that. You need that initial spark, right? Yeah. And to have that throughout is great. But more importantly, what's going to make it last long term is how to get through those things, mm-hmm. right? Yeah, that's for me.
Yeah.
Right.
What about you, Mr. Brian B?
I would I would echo that sentiment and just add that it's communication, right? And mm-hmm. it's like it's being your honest true self with that person.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And communicating that effectively to the other person and having the other person understand. Mm-hmm. It's not just like you're telling your truths and all that. It's like how is that being processed
mm-hmm. from the other
person and reciprocated
they're, back. They're not like just saying like, oh
yeah because you could kind of bare your soul, bare your heart and all that stuff, but like if it's not landing, connecting or whatever, then mm-hmm. like, you know, you gotta figure out what that means, right? Mm-hmm. So I think having the understanding but like having the other person comprehend that as well, mm-hmm. it's like in both ways, right?
So you're looking for like a connection, like communication is like important for
the but like taking it a step further and being like, it's not just communicating, it's like understanding and
I hear you, but do I feel you?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That type of thing. Well, about you, Foldak Dick, what is the modern day man looking for?
In like, I mean, I really can't put any better than you two. Can I just have the answer of both of you guys? I mean,
is there anything you want to add though, or like maybe like personal? What you
maybe
you
like
want?
you'd like
let's say like if you're out there dating, right?
Okay.
And like, what would attract you to somebody?
Yeah.
Like, what is it that you want?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, I really can't get past anything more than just communication, man. That's
the
number one thing.
Yeah, for sure.
So say there's two girls that you like, we're all talking to,
and right.
they both, you guys communicate. You guys can talk to them both easily and whatnot. What one aspect? What would be the separating difference? Like what can they have that separate other than looks and whatever?
Oh, it's vibe, man, for sure. There's no two people that are gonna react to the same mm-hmm. way that I talk to them. Mm-hmm. There's no.
Yeah.
So what aspect do you guys look for?
You know, it's a good one is like humor, mm-hmm. like how, like, again, going back to like how you react to a situation, it's like, can you laugh about it? Mm-hmm. Like, how serious do you take it?
Yeah. Right.
And like,
that's big.
You know, can you like, how do you process it and like get mm-hmm. past that or whatever it is?
Yeah.
So I think humor is a very direct way to like mm-hmm. understand another person. It's like the flip side of like being all serious, right? It's
right.
Like,
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you know, working through all the serious stuff that's important in communicating, but it's like, then how do you just like vibe and listen? Mm-hmm, like, mm-hmm. Just relax.
Yeah.
I feel that too.
For sure.
Like, if you can't joke around with someone, then it kind of like, for me, like, that's really important.
It can't be all, it can't like, be just a business partner.
Yeah. Right? Like, the sarcasm and stuff. Mm-hmm. Like,
for sure.
I need to laugh at, like,
yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Maybe to add on a little bit too, it's like, you just have to basically intertwine each other through the different phases, right? Because obviously at the beginning, you're obviously going to vibe with each other. You're going to have that banter. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But like, soon enough, that banter has to evolve into something.
Right.
You can't have banter your whole life.
Exactly. You
know? So it's something that you have to evolve with together. And mm-hmm. I think that's the number one thing to look for.
The growth, right?
The growth of things,
yeah. What about you, Nelly, no?
I think the ability to do stuff with each other.
Yeah.
Like it's kind of like, I know it sounds corny and everybody says, but like having a best friend.
Yeah.
I think that's
super important.
Yeah. You could do like literally anything with that
partner. For sure.
Like, it's good to have your alone time too, but at the same time, you should be able to do anything. Like go out, get drunk and like
for sure.
roast each other all night.
Yeah,